Howdy here. Look at this little peach. Welcome to part two of the best bow we can make for $1,000. It's gonna be a great day. We're gonna load this thing out, kit it out, and make it the best possible bow we can make for $1,000. Partner. If you're just joining us for this little mini series, last week we built this dart in consequence. This week, we're just trying to make Fred Bear proud.
That's right.
We got the Bear Alaskan XT. We're going to kit it out, make it as good as we can, keeping our budget in mind, and it's going to be a great day.
Let's spend $1,000.
Yeah, let's spend some money. First,
I just can never seem to turn down a peach.
First, we'll hit the hydration station real quick. Got one of Josh's favorites right there.
What's that funky stuff you got there?
It's kombucha.
I always knew you were some dirty hillbilly hippie. I think I tried that once and wanted to vomit.
I went from cowboy to mountain hippie in a matter of about 30 seconds on the video.
He's a chameleon, folks.
The part of this series that really excites me is how awesome can we make something given some constraints? Yeah, how can we best do that?
I got a grand, what can I get?
And can we make it 99% as good, 98% as good, 95% as good?
Yeah, how close can we get to this $2,500 bow build?
Yeah, we're going to find out. 33 inches axle to axle. 6 1/4 brace height, 529 MSRP, 70-pound peak weight, Picatinny integration on the front, which is a nice way that people have been planting stuff on their guns for a while. IMS integration on the back if you want to take advantage of that. This bow has a few more integrations, a few more bells and whistles compared to the old Consequence. Trophy Ridge Propel, limb-driven rest, $99. Black Gold Ascent Whitetail, $209. Black Gold Quick Link Picatinny Rail Adapter, $79. Boning Lynx Quiver, saving us some cash, 20 clams. Podium 12-inch bar, far above average size, $79.
It's a hog.
Podium 8-inch back bar, $69.99. Redline back bar, gonna get that back bar, $40. Josh actually just got done reviewing this video. Give us a couple of key pieces. Like, what'd you like about it yourself?
Honestly, for the money, I was very impressed with all the specs, everything that you came out with. It felt really darn good, didn't have a ton of vibration for the price point that it was at. For $530, and to have the integration that comes with it, I mean, you can't buy that integration.
Like, yeah, how about the speed to price ratio? Is there one better?
I don't think so. I really don't. Like, that's the gem in Bear's line, hands down. Like, yeah. It's going to be really hard to beat that bow. And they have other bows in the line, but for that price point and what you're getting, it's like, I don't know why you'd look at a different bow.
If you guys want to see Josh's whole review video, I'll have that link down below. And if this bow is something that's just like, oh, it's a little far outside my price point, I'd recommend the Bear Adapt Plus Ready to Hunt. It's a great ready-to-hunt package, under $600, and honestly, Josh and I couldn't beat it, so we can't beat it. Check it out. That's the best back bar price I know of.
I don't think there's a cheaper one. I'm working on it, though.
Yeah. All right. Name that movie. It was time to bust open the Bear Alaskan XT and get to building. Slate gray color here. We will get the accessories mounted on the bow. I like this back bar solution. It was simple, straightforward, and straight in front of you. Black Gold Ascent Whitetail. Something that you could actually save some money on, but the sight is at the core of your bow setup. Where did it go? Every once in a while, you throw a part under the fridge. Having a great bow sight is something I want to rely on when it really matters. So we spent a little more money here. This Picatinny adapter was an extra cost as well, but it allows for third axis adjustment and to use the integration, providing a very clean attachment. Trophy Ridge Propel drop away. Get the soft knots, get the D-loop tied on. Make sure everything is level and clean, including the rail, including the sight picture, because when you start shooting at distance, that becomes really important. Get our quiver mounted on. Simple, detachable, cost-effective. And like that, we got a bow. Time to take it to paper and see where we're at.
So now we're to the point where we need to run this thing through paper. And if paper's good, we'll put your peep in, tie it in place, and you're ready to sight it in.
Bear Alaskan XT, first arrow through my bow. Draw length feels nice.
That's a good thing.
Oh, sweet mother of tares.
Got a gasher. So that's a tip. Point and tip, and that's a wheeling. But let me look at something. Round two. She a bit better. Still a tiny bit right, but a lot smaller hole. Bear knock height. So we need to shorten this one where it's touching here. And just off there.
After getting the bow into the draw board, timing was a little bit out on the bottom cam, so we're just getting this thing twisted up, trying to get our timing just right so we can get that perfect bullet hole through paper and get it outdoors and onto the range.
Still a little point low, but it's better.
Okay.
So we may have to move the rest.
So now we're just making a small adjustment to the rest, right?
Yep, just move it up a little bit. Because we're timed now, so we know that part's good. So we're going to move the rest up a little. Just skoosh.
Just a smidge.
Oh, we got a hole. Yahtzee. Oh, so sexy. That's what we want.
Peep, speed, tape, take it outside, and put it to the test.
Time for speed.
A little speed test. See what this old Alaskan XT will do through the chrono. And that'll get us a starting point for our sight tape.
Hammer time. There you go.
Oh. We got a little speed demon on our hands here.
Well, it should be faster than the other one. So.
We've got our balloon set. 100 yard shot. What do you call your little dirt bike here? Your little, is it midlife crisis or what do we call this?
No, that's my slingshot. this is just my fun toy. This is my little funzilla.
We're trying to find a hundy.
How about a hundy?
Are you on it? Here. Dang, boy, you done this before?
Once or twice.
Now we have a number to beat. That's 14 arrows last time it took us with the consequence. Today's a much nicer day. What do you think about our weather, Josh?
Boy, it's pretty beautiful. Hard to argue with, man.
Sun's out.
Feels like springtime.
Feels like spring. It's beautiful.
Considering it was like freaking 12 degrees the other day, this feels pretty damn nice.
Yeah. All I did was set my 20. We're guesstimating sight tape based on chrono. We're gonna send it. Arrow number one. What if we did it one arrow, Josh?
That would be a miracle. But still rather impressive. Your left and your drops, great. You're at the top of the balloon.
I see height. It left and high.
You could totally, Tim, you could do this in two shots if you make another good shot.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're left by a foot. Like you're out of the lungs. Did you see where it hit exactly?
Yep, I got it. Okay. I see it.
Yeah, you're still a little high though. I'd take a yard off.
Felt good about that. I like how this bow held. I've been pleasantly surprised with how both bows have held at these longer distances. Elevation was a big one. Now that we know we're in the ballpark. All right.
Got it.
Josh came out and staged that shot before we got here. I don't know what to call that, guys. Lucky, skill, good, a little bit of each. A very well-tuned bow by our friend Josh Jones behind the camera. And that's another bow build in the hopper.
What do you want to call it? You want to call it Tim's package? I totally put that on there, dude. Yeah. I'm doing a heartbeat. Hey, if you're going to buy that bow, what would you put on it? Tim's package.
Something like that. Yeah, guys, Josh thinks we're going to get these on the website, both bow builds. I'm going to test more with them this year. This has been really fun for me doing this. If you're getting into archery, these are great options. I have a discount code with Josh's website. It's just Tim C. Everything will link down below in the description, including Josh's channel. He's been a massive help with this series. We're going to sign off. That was two shots. That'll probably never happen again. And we'll catch you on the next one. Yo, Dan. Hey, the people want to know when we're going to do a shoot-off.
Today?
Today? Today? All right, coming soon. We're going to get a shoot-off. Part one, part two on my channel, your channel? No. All right, we'll figure it out. They'll look forward to that. It'll be good.